guys, good morning. Is it still morning? I feel like my day has been so long. I woke up at like 5 a.m. today and I am totally feeling it. So I am excited though, because wake up, why don't you put on some makeup? Who knows that song? So I just did a video, you guys. I will post it here on my Drop It Like It's Oily page and a little bit after I edit out the kids screaming in the background. That's always fun, right? So I just did my a new video of what I've been doing lately before I apply my makeup. I've been using the Art Skincare line, which is a cleanser, a toner, and a light moisturizer. I also do a scrub some mornings if I remember to, and then the Art Renewal Serum, which really primes your skin for this amazing Savvy Minerals makeup line that I'm about to show you how to apply it. And if you want to get more info on how to get your very own skincare products and makeup products, let me know, you guys. This is seriously skincare without all the BS, because so much of our skincare is loaded with toxins. Crazy fact, did you know that the average person applies over 300 chemicals per day? 80 of those chemicals are applied before you even eat breakfast. You guys, that especially goes for the ladies out there, because we all know we love our products. We've got, you know, our shampoo, our conditioner, our cleanser, our moisturizer, our makeup, on and on and on and on. And our bodies are constantly bombarded with all this crap, and we can only deal with it so much where our body's like, hold on, wait a minute, I can't take anymore. Okay, so the less crap that we use on our bodies, the better, okay? So, Savvy Minerals Makeup is the most amazing makeup line. It's cruelty-free, first of all, which is a huge deal. You guys, some of the info I've been reading on makeups and products that use animals for testing, it's really disturbing and really gross. It's like, come on, we don't need all this testing whenever we're using pure natural ingredients. So Savvy Minerals is cruelty-free. It also doesn't have bismuth. You guys, a lot of people have used mineral makeup in the past and said that they've either broken out, whatever. Bismuth is like a heavy metal that your skin does not need to be in touch with, okay? So we don't have that in our lines, paraben-free. It doesn't have a bunch of the BS. The foundation has arrowroot powder in it and kaolin clay. So research those two and see why your skin would love that. I totally just dropped my lid, so I need to grab it. So let me go ahead and get started. You guys, my name's Kelly from dropitlikeitsoily.com. And I'm a mom of 6, soon to be 7. Baby number 7 is due in September. And I'm gonna go ahead and get started with my makeup now. I'm using first the misting spray with my little brush. You guys, Savvy Minerals is coming out with a brush set very, very soon. I hear if not this month, then definitely next month. So I cannot wait for them, because they're synthetic, which is good because it's not real animal fur. I told you they're cruelty free. I put a little bit of my foundation in the lid, spritzed my brush, and now I can just apply it. Oh my gosh, and I just feel like my skin is just like soaking it right up because I prepped my face. It's so important to prep your skin. Like, you guys, if you're an artist, you would not want to use a canvas, right, that is bumpy and not fresh. So your skin is your canvas. You want to make sure that it's prepped correctly by using some good moisturizer and that it's clean, and then your makeup will just love it. And you can put the TV on for a few minutes, okay?
No.
No. Okay, hold on just a minute, I'll help you. So I'm just swirling my foundation around all over. And this is kind of funny because I got the wrong foundation color. I actually got a cool number 2 and I should be a warm number 2. But you know what? This makeup is very forgiving. I'm still going to use it and keep it for my concealer because if you have like under eye circles like I do, you want a lighter color foundation or color right under your eyes to give you a little bit of coverage there. Okay, so I've applied my foundation. So like I said, I'm using cool number 2, but I'm actually getting my warm number 2 very soon, so I'm excited to try that. Now I'm going to use my Crowned All Over. This is a bronzer. I also just ordered another bronzer. It's a little bit darker. I believe it's called Passionate because I need a little bit darker tone. And I'm just tapping it into the lid and then applying it with my brush. Now, the brush that I'm using, it's more compact. So that's really good to use with mineral makeup. And I'm applying it to like... they say 3 and E is a good way to remember where to apply your bronzer because you kind of want it in the hollows of your cheeks to accentuate that. Now I'm going to tap out a little bit of, I do believe you're blushing, and apply that to the apples of my cheek. So if you smile, you can kind of envision that little circle in the front of your face and kind of extend it back a little bit. And I love this color. It is so cute. It's a beautiful pink. And if you want darker build, you guys, you can always apply a little bit more. So that's really cool. I'm going to move on to my brows. I'm using Multitasker, which is a dark brown. And I just need to find my eyebrow brush. So I did a video tutorial, I think it's on my YouTube channel now, and it's probably on this page too, of some tips for your eyebrows. Where's my eyebrow brush? Y'all, I cannot find it. So I'm going to go with my other brush, it will have to work. So I can't keep y'all waiting all day. So it's just an angled brush. This one's a little bit bigger than what I normally use. So here is a tip, you guys. When you are filling in your eyebrows, just follow along where it naturally is. And also, I like to start kind of midway. So I'm not applying too much product too quickly, so it's not super abrupt in the center. If you have light hair, if you're blonde, or maybe even, I don't know, some redheads have darker eyebrows, but if you have really light hair, I'd encourage you to try the foundation dark number 1 as your brow filler because it's a little bit lighter than this. It's like a light brown instead of a super dark brown. And just filling in your brows really helps with framing your face. Like your eyebrows are they really do frame your face. They frame out your eyes and everything. I don't like the way that looks 100%, but I'm going to go with it because like I said, I couldn't find my other brush. Okay, next I'm going to move on to my eyes, and I have a best kept secret. This is a matte color, and I'm gonna tap a little bit into my lid. This is just really a great primer for your eyelids. Did you ever get that annoying crease in your eyelids where your eyeshadow just kind of like creased in? And then your whole look just is like no bueno. So this is a good way to keep your eyeshadow in check and really prime your eyelids. So I use Best Kept Secret there. And now I'm going to use a little bit of Wanderlust, which is like a shimmery white. I've really been enjoying this color so much lately. And I'm actually gonna use my fingertip, you guys. I'm gonna use my ring finger. And I'm gonna apply it like, oh, I got too much. I'm gonna apply a little bit to the inner corner of my eyes. And you can use a brush. I just feel like this gives me a little bit more product. And if you want to, you can even foil it, which means to get your brush wet, which is probably what I should do, but maybe I'll do that on another video. So by foiling, you're getting your brush wet and then applying your mineral makeup, and you get like a really cool effect. It makes it a lot more, the color a lot more crisp, and it's really pretty. And then I'm going to move on to the crease of my eyes. I'm trying to find multitasker again. So I'm gonna use multitasker and just apply that to the crease of my eyes with a little brush. And so just apply that to the crease of your eyes. And I also like to do underneath my eyes a little bit. And you see how it just makes my eye pop out, just gives me more definition. I'm gonna do the same thing to the other eye. And sorry, it's so much easier for me to look in my mirror. And I'm just gonna work that in. And so there you go, see? And that is how I love to do my eyes. And I'm going to go over that with a color called Determined. This is like a dark brown, but it has some sparkle, you guys, which I really like. So I feel like the multitasker gives me a deep, rich color, and then adding Determined on top of it, or Diffused. I'm getting them confused. Determined is a dark brown color I'm gonna use to just go over that crease to give me a little bit of shimmer. I'm just gonna work that in. I'm gonna do it on my other eye too. Okay, and that's what I do for my eyelids, for my eyeshadow. And let me show you what I do for my eyeliner. You guys, I love eyeliner. I'm going to use multitasker again. That's why it's called multitasker, because you use it all the time. And I have this tiny liner brush. I had another one that was way better, but got to use what I have. I just spritzed it with the misting spray. Sorry about the music in the background. And I put a little bit of the multitasker in the lid, and I'm swirling it around. So it's kind of liquidy now, so it's gonna be like a liquid eyeliner. I'm just gonna line my eyes. Like, get as close as you can to your eyelashes. And this way, it's really cool. You can either do like a really narrow line, or you can do it a little bit wider if you're looking for something a little more dramatic. I don't know if you can tell, but this eye has liner, this one does not. I'm gonna do my other eye, same thing. I have my color in the lid, just swirling it around with some of the misting spray. I always feel like one eye takes longer than the other.
But there we go. There's my eyeliner.
And you guys were hopefully admiring my oil shelf I have over here. My hubby makes them. You can find them at bluecedarmarket.etsy.com if you want a cute little holder for your oils. And this also can hold your diffuser necklace too, which is really fun. So I have my eyeliner on, and then I'm going to use my diamond dust. Tap a little bit in my lid. And I'm going to use a bigger brush for this. Just going to swirl it all over my face. And there we go. I need to put my mascara on too. Of course, Savvy Minerals is coming out with mascara very, very soon. And here is a tip for you guys. I'll tell you in just a second. Let me put my mascara on. Did you know that there is an oil for pretty much everything, even your lashes? So, can anybody guess which essential oils are fantastic for supporting healthy lashes? Turn that off, bud. Thank you. So, lavender is really good for healthy lashes, and cedarwood, and rosemary. So, lavender, cedarwood, and rosemary are so good for supporting healthy lashes. Cool tip, just add a drop or two each in your mascara and your lashes will love you for it. And I'm really curious to see if the new mascara that they're launching will actually be infused with Young Living oils already. Are you getting some water to drink? My little man is getting some water to drink from the tub. Is that refreshing? So there you have it, guys. I had my face prepped, did my makeup routine, and this is what it looks like. Oh, I forgot my lips. Whoa. I have, this is Wish. It's a really pretty color. And I am not a lipstick girl. Like, I normally don't like the way lipstick looks on me or the way it's applied. I feel like normally it makes my lips look really dry. But I really love the Savvy Minerals lipstick. Oh, he thinks I have lip balm. You want lip balm? There you go. He wanted some too. So this is a really pretty like purple color called Wish. And I normally wear it only, turn it off, bud. I normally only wear lip gloss, which by the way, you guys, best lip gloss ever, of course, is Savvy Minerals. It has peppermint essential oil infused in it. So not only is it very invigorating, but it really makes your lips plump up a little bit, which is really cool. So there you have it, guys. If you have any questions or need some color suggestions, holler at me at crunchykelly@gmail.com, or you can message me right here on Facebook. I would love to chat, but right now I have to get my little man distracted with something else. So I'll talk to you guys later. Have a great day. Bye.